The following segment is sponsored by Northwest Honda Dealers.
Thanks so much for watching Afternoon Live. You know, K2 has teamed up with Live 95.5 and your Northwest Honda dealers to create Kind is Better in hope to spread kindness and highlight those who spread it in the community. And today, we want to introduce you to students from Club Hope at Beaverton High School. Samantha Miller is here, Raina Ayala, and Kenna Reed is here. Welcome, you guys.
Thank you.
All right, I'm eager to hear all about Club Hope. So, Kenna, why don't you tell us about it?
Yeah, so last year in the fall, Club Hope was started. We started to notice that the numbers of homeless students at our school were rising really quickly. So we wanted to do something to help. And so our mission is to promote awareness, assistance, and outreach, and advocacy.
Wow, advocacy.
Yeah.
Whoa, okay, so wait, now tell me about this homelessness that's going on in the school. How can you tell? Are people actually saying that they're homeless, or are there some signs that you guys were picking up on?
So people are actually saying, I don't know how many people are comfortable with saying that they are homeless, but just the statistics, they tell their counselors, and yeah.
Yeah, wow.
And also the homeless liaison, Lisa Metinsana, she helps us like figure out the numbers to identify what students qualify
as homeless. A homeless liaison. Yeah. So this is really a crisis that we're in, isn't it?
Yeah.
So let's talk a little bit about this political advocacy, because I think that needs some diving into. Raina, tell us about that.
Yeah, so last year the city council proposed an ordinance to ban car camping. So this hasn't, it did pass, even though we went to visitor comment periods and tried to speak up about it.
Yeah, car camping. So that's basically when people are living in their cars?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so it was a ban that passed, but it didn't really take effect because it was declared unconstitutional. But our speaking did inspire a safe haven parking pilot program, which is really exciting.
Yeah. Parking pilot program. Okay, yeah. I like that. So actually, you guys have your voice heard.
Mm-hmm.
That's the whole, so how do you guys organize and get together?
Every Monday we have meetings after school, and we meet in our advisor, Rita Morgan's room, and we just go over new things that we can do. So recently we had a talent show at our school that fundraised for Club Hope. We raised $450 and a ton of donations.
Wow.
Yeah, so we just go over how we can further improve what we're doing now and what new things we can do.
Well, something new that you guys are doing are these Hope Baskets, right, Samantha?
So Hope Baskets were started several years ago by a student at Beaverton, and Club Hope kind of picked it up as a way to expand the program because, you know, when Hope Baskets first started, they made like 19, and last year we made about 130.
Whoa!
So Hope Baskets just have some fun things and some kind of more necessity type items, and then they're distributed to students who are experiencing homelessness throughout the year.
Right. So here's an example of a Hope Basket right here.
Yeah.
I see a blanket. So are the blanket, you don't think about some of the items that people need when they don't have a stable home environment, like a brush. It's just something as simple as just doing your hair, grooming.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So you guys have all of these products in there now. So the fundraising efforts, did that help with making some of the baskets?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. And what about donations? Do you guys receive those?
Yes. And we've been asking for more gift card donations so we could put them in each basket. Because I feel like students who receive a basket, it'd be nice if they could go out to the store and get what they want.
Yeah. Why not? Gift cards,
anything. Like even if someone wanted to donate some supplies for the baskets.
Sure.
Yeah.
So you students have it all together, and I love that you all are being kind to the entire community. What do you want us grown-ups to know?
Well, like Kenna said, donations are a huge help. Donations for the birthday baskets or just donations like of money help with the Beaver Den too, which is the clothing closet and food pantry at Beaverton High School.
Oh, the Beaver Den.
Yeah.
I kinda like that. I like that. It sounds comfy, cozy. But look at this picture. Oh, you guys have a for real closet situation happening in there. People can go shopping in there?
Yeah. So it's a bit improved since that picture was taken. That picture is from last year, I think, but right now we're actually working on getting brand new cabinets and painting all the walls in there to personalize it a little bit. And so we supply clothes, food, shoes, school supplies, toiletries, and all those items are donated by students at our school or community members. And Club Hope just helps out with organizing and kind of redesigning the closet.
You guys are fantastic. And you take this mission on. This is year round, mm-hmm. right? So, yeah. And what about summer? Do you take time off or no? Because homelessness doesn't end in the summer.
Yeah, no.
No, you're still on, right?
Yeah.
You guys are great. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank
Club
you.
Hope, I love it. All right, you know what we're going to do is have more information about Kind is Better, Club Hope over at Beaverton High School. These lovely students, all for you on our website at katu.com. Don't go away. More of Afternoon Live when we come back. I am so impressed with you.
Thank you.